Beloved Muslims, dear brothers and sisters, when the troubles that are facing the Muslims become deeper and deeper, when the plight of this Ummah intensifies, when the situation becomes harder and harder for the Muslims start looking left and right, trying to seek a solution or a guidance. They may wonder in the course of this, what would Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam have done had he been living with us facing the same situation? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dead. However, he left for us a divine guidance. He left for us a guidance in the forms, in the form of the Quran and his teaching, his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As a matter of fact, before he died, he time and time again talked about the times to come, about the challenges that are going to face the Muslims, about what is going to happen with this ummah. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as Abu Dawood rahimahullah recorded from the narration of Thawban, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يوشك أن تداعى عليكم الأمم كما تداعى الأكلة إلى قصعتها. Nations are about to gather against you as people invite one another to eat from a platter of food. The Sahaba radiallahu anhum were amazed and they asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمِن قُلَّةٍ نَحْنُ يَوْمَئِذٍ. Are we going to be a few in number then? And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered by saying, لا بل أنتم كثير ولكنكم غثاء كغثاء السيل ولينزعن الله من قلوب عدوكم المهابة منكم وليقذفن في قلوبكم الوهن. قالوا وما الوهن يا رسول الله؟ قال حب الدنيا وكراهية الموت. He said, no, you'll be in great numbers then, but you will be like the upper layer that float above the flood, that goes in the direction of the flood wherever it goes, like the foam, the white foam that has dirt above the surface of a flood, which is a useless and of no power thing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take away your fear from the heart of your enemies and will instill al-wahn in your heart, weakness in your heart. They said, O Rasulullah, wa ma al-wahn? What is going to cause this weakness that you are talking about? He said, حب الدنيا وكراهية الموت. The love for the life of this world and the hatred for death, clinging to this life and hating the life to come. This is how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam analyzed the condition of the Muslims when they will become in great numbers yet weak, which precisely apply to our condition nowadays. And before talking about this deep analysis of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and talking about how damaging it is for us to cling and to love this life at the expense of the hereafter, we have to clarify something very important. That when we talk about the love of this world, we are talking about a state of the heart. It is a matter that relates to the condition of the heart. So actually, when we talk about this subject, we address both the rich and the poor. We cannot say that the rich is attached to this world, yet the poor is not attached to this world. Rather, the poor could be more attached to this world than the rich. So we are talking about a state of the heart. And this applies to every person. And we have, in order to understand how harmful it is for us to cling to this life at the expense of the hereafter, go to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and see why this matter causes us to be very weak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created us and who made this life a test for us and who put the rules for that test and who provided for us the tools so that we be successful in this test, He said, teaching us, He said, اعلموا أنما الحياة الدنيا لعب ولهو وزينة وتفاخر بينكم وتكاثر في الأموال والأولاد. Know that the life of this world is nothing but a play and a passing delight and a beautiful glamorous show and a cause for boastful vying with one another and racing with one another and a greed for having more and more riches and more children. Now, there is nothing wrong with enjoying our children or enjoying our wealth or enjoying halal entertainment or enjoying life. There is nothing wrong in this. And we have to be absolutely clear. The problem is when all of this become at the expense of the Akhirah. When all of this distract us from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us. When we would indulge in the haram in order to attain these worldly gains. When we care no more for what Allah said, when we care no more for what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, this is when the love of this world becomes fatal for us. And this is when this disease causes us to be very weak, rather dead in some cases. So here is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about the love of this world. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, he expressed for us what is his, what represent his deep concern about this ummah. He clearly stated, as Al-Imam Bukhari recorded, فَوَاللَّهِ مَا الْفَقْرَ أَخْشَى عَلَيْكُمْ ولكن أخشى أن تبسط الدنيا عليكم كما بسطت على من كان قبلكم فتنافسوها كما تنافسوها فتهلككم كما أهلكتهم. He said, by Allah, I don't fear poverty for you. This is not of the concern of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah is the most knowledgeable about what served the greater good of the people. Yet he said, by Allah, I don't fear poverty for you. Now look at the condition of our ummah. Look at the condition of the Muslims. Look at the condition of us. Some of us live in constant fear of poverty. While this is not the concern of the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, rather his concern was, وَلَكِنْ أَخْشَى أَن تُبْسَطَ الدُّنْيَا عَلَيْكُمْ كَمَا بُسِطَتْ عَلَى مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلٍ. Rather my fear or my concern for you is that the dunya, the life of this world will be opened up with its wealth upon you as it was opened up for those who were before you. And you start competing with one another over it, and it will ruin you as it ruined them. This is, was the fear of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam upon us. Why all of this concern? Why is that warning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in many ayat about this word? Because dear brothers and sisters, when we love this word and the love continue to grow in our heart, we will adore it. And if we adore this life, it becomes an objective. It becomes all what we care for in this life. And when it becomes our objective, then everything we do in this life becomes for the sake of dunya. And when we do everything for the sake of dunya, we lack the ikhlas. We lack doing things for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the sake of akhirah. And if we lose ikhlas or we lack ikhlas, expect everything, expect anything. Because by not having ikhlas, we destroy the very soul of this deen, the very foundation of this deen. And after that, you can expect conflicts, fights, and people who care for nothing more than this materialistic life. As a matter of fact, people will start doing the righteous work for the sake of this dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned all of those people who seek other than Allah by their righteous work, by saying, مَنْ كَانَ يُرِيدُ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا وَزِينَتَهَا نُوَفِّ إِلَيْهِمْ أَعْمَالَهُمْ فِيهَا وَهُمْ فِيهَا لَا يُخَسُونَ أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ فِي الْآخِرَةِ إِلَّا النَّارِ وَحَبِطَ مَا صَنْعُوا فِيهَا وَبَاطِلٌ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Whoever cares for no more than the life of this world and its glitter, نوفي إليهم أعمالهم فيها. We shall be paid them for all that they did in this life in full. وهم فيها لا يبخسون. And they will not be deprived of any of their just due in it. However, أولئك الذين ليس لهم في الآخرة إلى النار. It is they who will not have in the life to come anything but the fire. وَحَبِطَ مَا صَنَعُوا فِيهَا وَبَاطِلٌ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. And all that they did in it will go in vain, and all their work, righteous work, will become worthless. So if we start doing things for the sake of this dunya, we will convert this means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us to facilitate for us the fulfillment of our objective in life, our purpose in life. Allah had made this dunya as a means for the akhirah. But when we seek it, we convert it, we make it an objective, and anything other than the dunya becomes the means. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has forewarned that a time will come when people will seek the knowledge of the deen not for the sake of the deen, and will seek this life by the work that must be done for the life to come. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith which was recorded by Ad-Darimi, وتفقه لغير الدين والتمست الدنيا بعمل الآخرة. That people, a time will come when people will seek the understanding of deen not for the sake of deen, and people will seek this life by the work of the life to come. This is, dear brothers, how damaging it is to cling to this life at the expense of the hereafter. Moreover, if we are to give our heart for this dunya, we ought to develop a respect and honor for it while it does not weigh anything in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How sinful it is to honor something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala consider insignificant. Allah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith that all of you know, لو كانت الدنيا تزن وعند الله جناح بعوضة ما سقى منها كافرا شربة ماء. Had this word equated in the sight of Allah, a wing of a mosquito Allah would not have given a disbeliever in it a sip of water. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has given the companions a practical lesson, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam once passed by a carcass of a goat that had a defective ear, and he asked his companion, "Who among you will pay such and such dirham to buy this carcass?" And they said, "Oh Rasulullah, had this goat been living, we would not have bought it because it is defective, let alone buying it while it is a carcass." Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he said, "فوالله للدنيا أهون وعلى الله من هذا عليكم." He said, "By Allah," and he doesn't need to make an oath, but it is to engrave this fact in our heart. He said, "Wallahi, by Allah, dunya, this life, the life of this world, is lower in the sight of Allah than this to you." So when we respect it, when our standards become materialistic, when we appreciate people and respect people based on dunya standards, and we forgot the standards that are in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we would be reversing the truth. We would be honoring that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not honor. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي فاستغفر. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Dear brothers and sisters, we are talking about the damaging effect of clinging to this life at the expense of the hereafter. And I would like to again clarify that when we talk about the life of this world, this topic is addressed to everybody, the poor and the rich, the affluent and the powerful, and those who are powerless and who are doesn't have anything. Why? Because this matter relates to the condition of our hearts and how our hearts are attached to this, the life of this world. Dear brothers, clinging to this world and loving it at the expense of the hereafter will becomes a stumbling block between the person and attaining anything of benefit for one's deen, because it is a major distraction. It distracts people from doing the voluntary deeds, and then it will take them a step further by making them neglect the obligatory deeds, and after that, at one point, people will neglect the whole religion. And this is mentioned in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُلْهِكُمْ أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَلَا أَوْلَادُكُمْ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Oh, you who believe, let not your children, your wealth, divert you from the remembrance of Allah, and whoever does this, it is they who are the true losers. We can enjoy our wealth and we can enjoy our children, but when they distract us from whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to do, when they become the cause that drives us to commit haram, in this case, they would be a cause for our true loss in the hereafter. So, yes, we can enjoy our wealth and children, but they cannot divert us from the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after describing for us the believers and the reasons for the beliefs, in some cases he mentioned to us that preferring the life of this world was the cause of their belief and rejecting the truth. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ مُسْتَحَبُّ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا عَلَى الْآخِرَةِ. This is because they preferred this life over the hereafter. So again, when we love this world and its love becomes settled in our heart, this becomes an obstacle between us and deriving any benefit for our deen or for our akhirah, and it would become our major concern, our only concern. And when the dunya becomes our major concern, the warning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for us is that we cannot really feel the fulfillment and be satisfied in this life, no matter how rich we become. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ كَانَتِ الدُّنْيَا هَمَّهُ فَرَّقَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ أَمْرَهُ وجعل فقره بين عينيه ولم يأته من الدنيا إلا ما كتب له. Whoever his main concern is the life of this world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will scatter, will cause all his affairs to be scattered. So he will become out of focus. Whatever he does, he would not be able to derive any satisfaction or fulfillment. Rather, he is always out of focus. وَجَعَلَ فَقْرَهُ بَيْنَ عَيْنَيْهِ. And he will always feel that he is poor. You know why, dear brothers and sisters? Because the true meaning of richness is the richness of the heart. And if people are not rich at heart, then no matter how they have of the wealth of this world, this would not be enough for them. And you see, on the other hand, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ جَعَلَ هَمَّهُ هَمَّا وَاحِدًا هَمَّا الْمَعَادِ كَفَاهُ اللَّهُ هُمُّهُ الدُّنْيَا. Whoever makes his only concern the concern of the hereafter, the concern of al-akhirah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will suffice him all other worries. And whoever branch out in his worries in the different affairs of this world, Allah will not care, as the hadith states, in any of its valleys he be destroyed. Allah will not care for him anymore. So here are some of the reasons why we should really remember the hereafter and not have a love for this life that will take us away from fulfilling the commands of Allah and commands of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers and sisters, do you know what is the most important key? It is not the key for a new house. The most important key is the key of paradise. And we'll never be able to have this key without having the key of righteousness or to righteousness. And today I will give you that key to righteousness. This is the secret of righteousness. The secret or the key that leads to righteousness, dear brothers and sisters, is constant remembrance of the purpose of life. This is what made the Sahaba radiallahu anhum a unique generation, a generation different than us. When we have this constant remembrance of the purpose of our life, then everything will be tailored according to that purpose. The way we eat, the way we drink, the way we live our life, the amount of attention we give to every aspect of our life will be tailored according to the purpose of our life. The way we build our houses, the way we buy our cars, it will affect every aspect of our life. You know, one time Umar ibn al-Khattab entered to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he saw the marks of the reed mat on which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sleeps upon, on his back. He saw the marks because it was tough and rough, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to sleep on it. And Umar ibn al-Khattab really felt very sad, because Rasulullah is the best of mankind. He is better than any other king, and if he want, he could be in a better worldly condition. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw this in him, and when he asked him, you are better than all other kings, why don't you have a more comfortable mattress? And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, أَمَا تَرْضَى أَن تَكُونَ لَهُمُ الدُّنْيَا وَتَكُونُ لَنَا الْآخِرَةِ. Will you not be happy if they own the whole of this world, but we have the hereafter for us? So again, if the purpose of our life is always present in our mind, this affects every aspect of our life. This changes our way of life, and everything will be tailored to serve that purpose, and worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, what matters in the hereafter is what lasts, what we can take to the hereafter. We cannot take our wealth, we cannot take our children. The only thing that stays with us in our grave is our righteous deeds, is our prayer at night, is our attendance to the masjid, is our service for the Muslim community, is the Quran that we read, is the tasbih that we make, okay, it is the dhikr. All these things are the things that enlight our grave and remain with us even when the dearest people to us leave us alone in our grave. This is a reminder, and the purpose of this reminder is for us to have this concern, the concern for the Akhirah. Our look for this life is very unique. Islam perspective about life is very unique, because even when someone enjoys his wife with the proper intention, will have a reward for it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants our heart. We can employ this life, but we should not be employed for it. We can use it, but we should not allow it to use us. We can have it by our hands, but not allow it to enter to our heart. Our heart should be for Allah and Allah alone. أقول قولي هذا وأقيم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.